If there is anything I've learned from being in the Bleach fandom, and I think anyone can agree that's in the Bleach fandom, is that patience literally is a virtue, because we are one of the only fan bases that has waited such a long time and has reaped the most biggest rewards. Because not only are we having an anime coming back when no one thought it was possible, but my god, did I ever think that throughout YouTubing that I would ever think about talking about a Bleach chapter again. And yes, you had heard me. Yes, I don't have a scam for you at the moment. These are in fact leaks, and of course you're going to hear many stuff throughout the rest of the week itself. The new Shonen Jump chapter, with the new Shonen Jump magazine, as you can tell, I'm gassed. I'm really gassed. So with the new Shonen Jump magazine that is coming out on Sundays officially, because it's Monday in Japanese time, we will be getting an announcement within that magazine saying Bleach will be having a 20th anniversary 73 page celebrationary chapter, which is massive. That's bigger than the first Burn the Witch chapter that we had. Was that the one shot or was that the first chapter? I can't remember. It doesn't matter. But it's a pretty big, significant amount of pages for a chapter. I think that will be including obviously a color page as well. It's a pretty big deal. This is again to commemorate. And the question is, the really important question is, which is now going to cause a lot of controversy, maybe in a good way, maybe not, who knows, what is the chapter going to be about? Obviously we've got Can't Fear Your Own World, which is 6 months after the Thousand Year Blood War arc. We've got We Do Not Always Love You. I literally had to look on the back of my bookshelf right there to remember what it was. And that is 3 years after the Thousand Year Blood War arc. The question is this going to be within the 10 years of Bleach, of that time skip that we didn't get? Which I think is, again, if you've watched videos of mine talking about the anime, is that that is a perfect excuse for the anime to really delve into some other topics, do some side stories, do some in-canon filler. If the Bleach Thousand Year Blood War does really well, we could have like a Dragon Ball Super situation where we go across that new content within that time skip. I think that that's important. However, are we going to get a 74-page chapter within that? It's very well possible. It is extremely possible. Now I have to think, what do I want and what is rational? And what I want and what is rational is the next step. And I think either way, whatever you get, whether it's a chapter within the within the 10-year time skip, whether it's a chapter in between that or a chapter after the sequel, well, not the sequel, the time skip, the 10-year time skip, it's such a big, massive W, because no matter what, not only are you getting more content, but you're also getting more content after the Blood War arc. Like, even if we don't get light novel stuff, even if we don't get, you know, the two novels that we talked about, you know, we're going to get more content after the Thousand Year Blood War arc, and that's good for production, that's good for the anime, that's good for long-term jeopardy. Thousand Year Blood War arc is not the end-all be-all for Bleach, it seems, and that's really, really exciting, as well as we got Burn the Witch, you know. This is massive. It really is, and I'm not over-exaggerating here, because, okay, say we got some new content, again, 74 pages, you know, whatever's going to be in that is going to be mad, and there has to be a reason for it, you know. I mean, you could say, oh, well, let's see what could it be about? I mean, the most you could say, let's see what everyone else is doing. Say we get a new chapter and that's after the 10-year time skip. What's everyone else doing? What's Ashin doing? What's Chad doing? You know, all those characters we didn't really get to see after the time skip. Sure, we could have a slice of life thing. We could have a slice of life thing. And that goes on to question, well, if it's a slice of life thing and we get to see what everyone else is doing, then how is it going to end, right? Like, are we really just going to get 74 pages of just nothingness? Possibly. But again, that could be a good episode for like the anime, I guess, to round it all off. But at the same time, is usually with chapters they end off on cliffhangers, and for something as big as this, I don't know, I don't think it's the end all and be all, because I generally think that this is going to be, the rational business side of me and also the fan in me wants a what happens after the time skip. And I'm telling you, because there's already been illustrations within the Bleach Jet art book, Kazui and Ichigo. Ichigo's his kid and Ruki's kid having their own spin-off. Now, of course, I already know what you're going to say in the comment section, and I already am way ahead of you. Oh, but what about Boruto? I know, Boruto Naruto is his sequel, is questionable, to say the least. And not everyone is happy about it, and I completely understand. Not everyone is it is what it is, right? However, I don't think it's that bad, because I think people forget the fact that Dragon Ball Z you know, is actually a Gohan spin-off. You got Dragon Ball, which is Goku's, and then you've got Gohan, which is, you know, Dragon Ball Z. However, the difference between Naruto or Boruto and Dragon Ball Z, yes, the fundamentals is about Gohan, however, Goku is still the more prevalent main character within that spin-off or sequel, so to say. And the same with Boruto is that they've regressed Naruto and Sasuke in Boruto, and I think that's what people dislike. But of course, Boruto is the new gen sequel, and people grew up with Dragon Ball Z, so there is a bit of bias there. But if this is Kubo working on it, and he does a sequel, it can be done well. It really can, as long as, you know, it goes the Dragon Ball Z route, and like Ichigo is still prevalent, as well as Kazuha and Ichigo and blah 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 blah. We could have a, do you know how mad that would be? So not only after the Thousand Year Blood War arc, and we could get some stuff in between the 10 year time skip, and then the final chapter, we could then have a sequel. And boys, like, this isn't, you know, Bleach Brave Souls is doing well. That's good for marketing. That clearly has more content to go through. They're even talking about on the anniversary that they want to do the 7th anniversary. So, you know, they're thinking long term. Shueisha are clearly thinking long term. So we're getting a new chapter, and I'm absolutely gassed. Like, I'm trying not to swear because I don't want to get demonetized, but I am so gassed. And this brings up, so I never thought I'd talk about a chapter of Bleach again. I thought in 2016 that would be the last time we got new Bleach content, more things to speak about, more things to learn. Kubo has clearly given us some more content, and 74 pages at that, and it's going to be mad. So next week on Wednesday, depending on whenever I get the early drafts, or even on Sunday, we are going to be talking about a Bleach chapter, and it is going to be mad. So the question is, I guess what we're going to talk about is, let's see who's right. Let's see who's right in the comment section down below, and I'll give you a shout out if you crack it. You know, what is the logical situation, and what is the thing that you would want the most? Is it going to be Slice of Life-y? My prediction here is that it's going to be Slice of Life, and then it's going to go into Kazuha and Ichika, and then it's going to go into like a little mission or something cute like that, and then at the end, maybe a shadowy figure, maybe a little cliffhanger. If there is a cliffhanger at the end of the chapter, it's not over. It's not over, and there's going to be more, and it's going to be gas. Maybe that this chapter is to see how much interest, I mean, obviously there's going to be interest, but how much interest there is for there to be more content in the future, and to get people's reactions to it. But whatever there is, if there is a cliffhanger at the end, it's a done deal. We got more stuff coming. It's so exciting to be a Bleach fan right now. And also as well, I remember tweeting, if you don't follow me on Twitter, go follow me on Twitter. I wrote on Twitter as well that Kubo had finished his stuff for Jump. I may have made a video on it, I can't remember, but Kubo said that he had finished a project for Jump like a month ago, and we all thought it was Burn the Witch, admittedly. It seems to be that wasn't the case, and it was actually Bleach. So yeah, this is insane. I'm so excited. So yeah, if there's any more news and updates, I'll obviously update you guys in a video. If the scan comes out, I will post it on Twitter. I probably won't do a video on it unless there is some significant news, but other than that, yeah, go follow me over there. I'm gonna catch you guys later. You guys of course have this fine Devin Hansen, as always, people. I will catch you guys next week for a Bleach chapter view. Peace out.